in the midst of that prayer, what I heard within my prayer, and it wasn't audible, it was within, is over with. Today's the day. Today is the day that you're going to serve me. Today is the day that you're no longer going to be a Latin king. That's over with. You're going to serve my kingdom. You know, I told people, you know, I took off my crown, I pick up a cross, and I'm following Christ. You know, oh man, that's what it's about.
And you stand today as a testimony to every single person who's listening. Marvel not that I say to you, you must be born again.
You know, my family seen it, especially the ones who do not believe in Christ, they really were taken back, like, wow, you're pretty serious with this stuff, huh? I'm like, yeah, why do you say that? Like, well, we don't think a church would have went out their way to make a video on you if they really didn't believe in you, if they really didn't see the authenticity of your faith in that. And just to hear and to see again how people were just touched by the video, and to see that God was able to once again show up and show out. After the video came out on Harvest website, and it started getting a lot of views, but then a brother of mine in my small group, he was like, hey, Anthony, he's like, I had a brilliant idea of putting it on YouTube, and I put it under Latin King. If anybody looks for Latin King videos, your video's gonna pop up. Oh, wow, this has a great implication here. I'm like, because masses of Latin Kings or affiliated gang members are gonna be looking to the site to see a promotional video when, in contrast, this is about Jesus Christ. So a few weeks went by, and he was like, hey, there's a lot of comments on these videos. I'm like, hey, I got an idea. He's like, what? Why don't you take my cell phone number and put it on the video? Within weeks, I've started having numerous people call me, from former Latin Kings or ex-Latin Kings who became Christians, or other individuals who just were inspired by the video, and just people who just thought that the phone number was fake and they just wanted to try it out. They called me, and sure enough, I'm on the other line. I answered the phone, and it was a blessing. I actually even had three kings that I was incarcerated with that actually contacted me based off the video. So I was like, wow, how awesome God could take that video and just use it for His glory. One thing that I have learned, and I'd say the hard way since I've been released, is that if I don't succumb to Christ, if I don't submit to Him, that I could easily take steps back to my former life. I used to sell drugs while I was in prison. I used to sell drugs before I was incarcerated. So every now and then I go to struggle of, well, God's taking too long. Why don't I just go and act out on my own? Why don't I just go take care of the situation? When God's like, no, Anthony, in your life you could have two results. You could have the results that Anthony produces, or you could have the results that I produce. A brother of mine, a co-leader of mine for Connect Key, took an interest in me as well. Like, wow, Anthony, you know, you're really pretty good at allowing God to flow through you and speak into people's lives. He's like, you know, God's put it on my heart to want to start a ministry in downtown Chicago. So basically, ever since the beginning of this year, I've come out here Monday through Friday to downtown Chicago, 8-9 hours a day, and I basically walk the streets of downtown Chicago pouring as much love as I possibly can. It's a blessing to see people getting detoxed off of heroin, off of alcohol, off of nicotine, and even just the simplest is what a hug can mean to somebody on the streets. Out of the midst of how dark the streets are in Chicago, there's still these little lights that are shining the love of Christ. I've seen just so many miracles out here. I've been able to be blessed to experience it, and just the reward of it itself is just so amazing, because I just leave more ministered to than I feel they do. By a lot of support and motivation and guidance by my flock leader and a lot of pastors and individuals in my life, like, yeah, why don't you go to Moody? You know, I never really thought about that. I'm like, all right, I'm gonna apply to Moody. What do I got to lose, right? So I took a leap of faith. A little over a month later, by God's grace, I was accepted to Moody. So for the next 5 years, it looks like I'll be here in downtown Chicago, studying the Word of God, being edified, being groomed, being mentored, being trained. Moody is going to be an astronomical blessing to me, and I believe that I will be also an immense blessing to Moody. I would highly encourage that everybody in the body of Christ identifies what's their transformational moment in life, what's their life testimony, and that they can share with as many people as they possibly can, because that's how people can realize and see, our God's alive, our God's real, our God is still performing acts every day through the lives of everyday people.